Good morning and welcome back to The Buzz, the place for all your latest entertainment news and hot gossip. We've got a full pot of tea brewing for you today. The latest from last night's Emmy winners and TikTok's newest power couple. I'm Calista Yost.
And I'm Kaci Lattimore. You're watching The Buzz. Let's start off with a sad goodbye to one of the most iconic families to have graced us with their reality presence. With 18 seasons over 13 years, Keeping Up with the Kardashians has become ingrained into our cultural references and a staple for reality television. In a very emotional post, Kim shared that the show will end after its 20th season. So here's to the most memorable moments, like Kim's diamond earring still lost in the ocean, the Kylie and Kendall Jenner before and after, and every single family fight the show will certainly be missed. So I'm just gonna miss Kylie. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna miss her way more than everybody else.
I don't know. Kourtney's definitely my favorite Kardashian. I think I align with her the most. She just has the energy, you know what? Like, you need to stop what you're doing because you're being a brat energy. Like, literally, Kim, there's people that are dying. Like, come on, you do not get a better take than that. I'm obsessed with Kourtney. And I also think lately, like, Khloé has been, like, kind of, because I remember, like, I was really big into season one, and Khloé really irritated me season one, but now I'm like, okay, you're going on me, Khloé. I like you, girl.
I really am going on her as well. I feel like with the whole latest thing with her on Instagram and then, like, the face filters and stuff, I feel like that's kind
of a
problem.
I honestly felt bad for her in that situation because I feel like that's something that, like, everyone does, but, like, she just got all the heat for it. But moving on, Bad Bunny spiced things up with a moving concert through the streets of New York. Taking social distancing to a new level, he stood atop a bus that drove throughout the streets and gave a full-blown concert. Now, I know I saw this video. I thought it was so cool, and I thought it was awesome that he had a whole caravan just going through the city, and the amount of things that had to go into that, like, it blew my mind.
I really feel like the creative team did do their thing with that, I guess, the actual 18-wheeler pushing somebody on the top, so I'm actually astounded by that. But actually, if I was on the road, driving past and seeing somebody perform at a concert, I feel like that would be kind of wild and very distracting when I'm driving.
Yeah, I know. I thought that was crazy. Yeah. Last night's Emmys broke records as well, with 130 cameras shot over this virtual show hosted by Jimmy Kimmel. Sloane has the latest with Who Took Home the Gold.
Thanks, guys. I've got the latest on which of your favorite TV shows took home a trophy. Watchmen picked up 11 Emmys last night, followed by an unsuspecting underdog. Schitt's Creek picked up 9 Emmys, breaking the record for the most Emmys awarded to a comedy series, making the hashtag #SchittSweep trending on Twitter. Continuing this record-breaking trend, Zendaya took home the Emmy for Best Leading Actress in a Drama Series for her role in Euphoria. This makes her the youngest to ever win the category. I mean, I love Zendaya and props to her, but I have to say, Schitt's Creek all the way, absolutely my favorite show. I just wanna say thanks, David, ew Alexis, and Moira finally won her Emmy. Back to you guys.
Yeah, I definitely loved Moira's acceptance speech. I thought it was so awesome, and I thought it was so amazing to see everyone, her and Zendaya, just be blown away by the fact that they won all of these awards.
Honestly, I actually haven't seen Schitt's Creek, so I would have to give it to Euphoria, and also with, like, the presence it has along entertainment, also different people around the world. I have friends that have hosted parties for Euphoria, so I mean, like, the influence is really there.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree. And speaking of influencers, America's TikTok heartthrob is off the market now. After weeks of denying the romance, Dixie D'Amelio and Noah Beck confirmed their relationship in her new Be Happy remix video. The two were pictured getting cozy on a beach and sharing a passionate kiss. Now, I know I'm big into TikTok, and I refuse to believe that Noah Beck is 19 years old. Like, that scares me a little bit, if we're gonna be perfectly honest. And just the TikTokers in general, it's just weird to me that that's my age group. Like, I'm there, that's me. I don't know, just throws me off.
I know, but having that connection, like somebody told us that she actually goes to Alabama, so just having that SEC connection and also having that entertainment connection with TikTok is kind of weird, but I'm actually with it, so when I get into TikTok some more, I will understand.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree, and I also thought, I was so surprised that Black Bear was in the video as well, because I was like, that's just something where I was just like not expecting it at all. Like, he just seems so adult to me, and I'm just like, where? When are there adults? Adults. No, that's illegal. But that's all we have for you today. Follow us on all our social media at SGTV at USC for more on the latest entertainment news. Catch you next time on The Buzz. Sometimes I don't wanna be happy. Don't hold it against me if I'm down.